Welcome, you are listening Radio Central News. I'm Chandni, and now news in detail. India's contingent tally on Wednesday surged to 5,85,493 after witnessing a sharp spike of 18,663 cases in the past 24 hours. According to the Health Ministry, after 507 more people were lost to the pandemic, the country's death toll has mounted to 17,400. However, with a constant betterment in the rate of recovery, cured and discharged cases now stands at 3,47,979 in India, and the number is 1,27,865 more as compared to the present cases under active medical supervision across the country at 2,20,114. The Regional Medical Research Center for ME Region at Dibrugarh in Assam has become the fourth laboratory in the country to successfully isolate SARS-CoV-2 virus, which can be used in the production of vaccine against the contagion in future. RMRC Dibrugarh is the third government laboratory in the country after NIV, Pune, CCMB, Hyderabad, and fourth overall after Bharat Biotech, a private biotechnology laboratory in Hyderabad, to isolate the virus in tissue culture. Health Ministry of Assam, Himanta Biswa Sarma, said this is important for development of COVID-19 vaccine, where virus grown in laboratory are inactivated by heat or chemical and purified for use as vaccines after preclinical and clinical trials. Amid ongoing border tussle between India and China along the line of actual control in eastern Ladakh, Defence Minister Rajnath Singh is likely to visit Ladakh on Friday to review the security scenario. Army Chief General M.M. Narwane will also accompany him. This would be the first visit of the Defence Minister since troops of both sides engaged into standoff. During the visit, the minister will also hold a high-level meeting with senior military leadership, sources in the defence establishment said here on Wednesday. He will also visit the Leh hospital to meet the soldiers who were injured during the violent clash with Chinese PLA in the Galwan Valley. The troops of India and China have been engaged in the stalemate at multiple locations in eastern Ladakh since early May. The tension escalated, which led to killing of 20 Indian soldiers in the Galwan Valley on June 15 in a violent clash with the Chinese troop. The Chinese side also suffered casualties, but they have yet not disclosed the details. Supreme Court on Wednesday rejected a plea for an entry bail to Mahendra Singh Yadav, former MLA and co-convict of ex-Congress MP Sajjan Kumar in 1984 anti-Sikh riot case. "We are not inclined to give any interim relief at this stage in the case to the petitioner," a bench comprising Justices Indira Banerjee and B.R. Ganwai said while hearing a plea seeking bail on the ground that the convict is corona positive. Nifty and Sensex closed at a positive note. Nifty closed at 10,430 and Sensex closed at 35,414.45. Despite positive waves in the market, share of state-owned oil and natural gas corp declined nearly 4% after the company reported its first ever quarterly loss, and share of Vodafone Idea plunged nearly 5% after the company reported a staggering ₹73,878 crore of net loss for the fiscal ended March 2020. Now news about precious yellow metal. Gold prices climbed to a fresh record high of ₹48,886 per 10 gram in the Mumbai bullion market on rupee depreciation, and as fears of a second wave of coronavirus infection boosted demand for the safe haven metal. The rate of 10 gram 22 carat gold in Mumbai was ₹44,780 plus 3% GST, while 24 carat 10 gram was ₹48,886 plus GST. The 18 carat quoted at ₹36,665 plus GST in the retail market. That is all for today's news bulletin. Stay tuned to Radio Central News for more updates.